Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and Mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Chicago Bears and the Dallas Cowboys. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. One man in the backfield, Elliott. He's going to get the football. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Brandon, the numbers look good in week 2 for Ezekiel Elliott. Dallas at Washington. I think the fantasy guys will like it, but he had a couple of fumbles and got benched in the 4th quarter.
Yeah, had 81 yards, but you're right. 4th quarter got put on the bench, so it'll be interesting to see what happens in Big D going forward.
And you know something? That's not unusual for a rookie running back. Ball security, it's a lot different in the NFL. You've really got to take care of it.
Ezekiel Elliott going to take it the distance. Touchdown, Cowboys! Ezekiel Elliott, 62 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. So a big-time scamper there to cap a touchdown on the opening drive.
Sets a tone, establishes not what you call a dominance, but a really good feeling for the team that just scored. But I've got to ask you, partner, what do the analytics say about that type of a run? Does it establish anything else for them?
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Onto the field now come the Bears. Carry for the tailback, Jeremy Langford. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so. So Langford the carry there. 4th round pick last year with Forte vacating to New York. A lot of the spotlight on Langford.
A lot of running backs have possibilities in Chicago. If he can emerge and eat up carries, I think he'll produce in a big way.
Langford again. Shedding the tackler that gives him some room. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A good-looking run there by Jeremy Langford.
And what I've always liked about him has been not just his versatility, but his perseverance. I think he's one of those backs that gets better as the game goes on and he gets increased carries. Does have some good toughness running inside. I remember when he's at Michigan State, at one point I did a game of his. He was listed as 3rd-team left corner, played cornerback, receiver, and running back for the Spartans.
Won a couple of Big Ten titles there as well. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Kadeem Carey, 52 yards. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be taken about the 12. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right, to be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Here's Prescott, and this one caught by Dez Bryant. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Finding time. He finds his target, Terrence Williams. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
And another thing that makes the comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receiver's breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. Now Prescott looking middle, and it's incomplete. Cole Beasley, the intended target, and it'll be second and 10. Yards still left on second down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's got time in the pocket. Out left side here to Bryant. And he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
A first down carry by Elliott. And some room to work. And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. So good for the Buckeyes last year, and he's taken that from the college game, showing some glimpses of it here in the NFL.
How about his last season with Ohio State? Over 1,800 yards, only one game where he didn't get over 100. And remember, he demanded the ball from then on out. I think they listened to him, and they were smart to do so.
And now they're giving it to him here on the next level. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Here we go. 1-9.
On second down, Elliott. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number 2, and they've got it here with a first down. They come out here in the eye. Now Elliott, and he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
Here we go. Come on, let's go. 1-9.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's 3rd and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He was trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. Now this will be the 9th play on this drive. They look to throw on 3rd and goal. And there's a flag on the field. Now Dan Bailey, 30 of 32 in field goal tries last year. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Bailey able to knock it through. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. This will be fielded at the 8. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
They'll throw on first down with Cutler. Checks it underneath to Langford. Look at the spin.
Balance.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
This is Langford on first and 10. And he stopped immediately there. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on 3rd after the run. Throwing here, Cutler. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. On first down, it's Cutler. Miller on the catch over the middle. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll be 2nd down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
On 2nd down, Cutler. Completion left side to Miller. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. Call it a gain of 3. And that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a 1/2 foot.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a 1-on-1 play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Now it's Cutler, and he's got Miller. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on 3rd. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. From the red zone now, here's Cutler on first down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And that'll make it 2nd and 10. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. 2nd down and 10. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. 2nd and 10 now. It's Cutler. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. On 3rd down, Cutler. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the 1st down as he's tackled at the 2. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. They'll look to run with Langford, and he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Now Cutler to throw on 2nd down. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
There are a good number of coaches that anytime they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
And let's see 6 defensive backs out there. They're in the dime here on 3rd and goal. Now Cutler. He's got time. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
3rd down is the down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get 3 to end the 1st half. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And Barth puts it through, and that will tie things up as we head toward halftime. And that 3-point tally now means we are even here toward the end of the 2nd quarter.
And what a way to end the half. Put some points on the board, feel better about yourselves as a team, and you're right back to even.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And we will likely not see another play here as they take the knee and head into the intermission all tied. So we have reached halftime here and a good one. 10-10 is our score. As we send you on over to Orlando, where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports halftime report. Larry, that's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. 15 yards through the air on a first down.
Partner, he got the DB on his horse on that play. He certainly sold like it was going to be a deep route before breaking it back on the comeback towards the sideline.
Now Cutler on first down. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into what? A huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot.
On second down, Cutler. Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. A gain of 3, second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
On second down, here's Cutler. Throw here is incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. So third and 7 and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
From the gun on third down, it's Cutler. Completion left side to Miller, and he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first.
Now, coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Back to the running game, Langford. And he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
And that's a good sign right there as we start the third quarter, because in the first half, not much space to run the football. And as we go into the half, we often think to ourselves, all right, what's the adjustment? What do they have to do? You know what a lot of the adjustments are? No adjustments. You know the game plan, been working on it all week. Maybe a little tweak here or there, a little bit better blocking. And now you're establishing the running game.
This is Langford. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
Set back is Langford. From the red zone now, here's Cutler on first down. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Again on second and 10, it's Cutler. And his throw's going to be incomplete. It's one of those ones that is so hard to judge, but defensive holding there, that's what the referee saw.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Everyone
shotgun, Cutler. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Jeremy Langford, the one he was looking to get it to. And that'll bring up a second and goal. But pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Now it's Cutler. And his pass, incomplete. Marquise Wilson, the one he was trying to get it to. And that is going to set up third and goal. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. On third and goal, Cutler. That's caught at the three. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Now stopped him in his tracks. And Barth puts it through, and they will take the lead at 13-10. So they don't get a touchdown here on this opening drive of the third quarter, but I think you still say mission accomplished as they come away from it with the lead.
Absolutely. You got to apply the pressure here, make the other guys play catch up for a while, and now you just hope your defense can step up and protect the lead.
Barth now after the made field goal to kick it away. Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. He's got the connection to Cole Beasley. And the QB steps over the line of scrimmage. That's an illegal forward pass.
And that is so rare, because at the different positions, you have to know different things. Wide receivers have to know where the first down line is. Quarterbacks almost always know where the line of scrimmage is.
Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long.
Three down, three down. Let's go.
Now Prescott. Deep drop. It's a gain of 7, and it'll be third down. Let's go. 7 yards remaining here on third down. Now in Arlington, it's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. And the Bears in the nickel. No, wait, they're in the dime. 6 DBs out there on third.
Could play an exotic coverage.
Here's Prescott. And this is going to be incomplete. Lance Dunbar is running back the intended target. And that's going to make it fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Bears take over. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. Puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Miller on the catch over the middle. It's an 8-yard pickup, and they're going to face a third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll try to run for the first with Langford. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll run with Carey. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
On second down, Cutler. This caught by Royal. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. On third down, Cutler. Quick hitter here, it's complete. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
That throw has to be a quarterback's dream, doesn't it? Big tight end, curling in the middle of the field, so it's great sight lines for him. And when they show their numbers back to the quarterback, when they sit down right there, that should be pitch and catch.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
He'll look to throw. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And they're going to speed things up here. He's back to throw. Surveying the field. Still back there. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Mitch Unrein in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. They'll look to throw. Finding time. Penalty marker is down here. Another pistol look here. Back to throw. To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. They find some open field here. Touchdown, Cowboys! Lance Dunbar, 66 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Yeah, part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
Kick it away after the touchdown. Set to return now. Here's Deontay Thompson. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Back to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now it's Cutler. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Jeremy Langford, the one he was trying to get it to. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. So third and 15, and an extra defensive back in the game now.
Flooding the passing lanes.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 7 yards on the carry there, but now they're staring at fourth down. Down four late. Got to go for it here on fourth down. Here we go. It's Cutler on fourth down. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. Two timeouts remaining defensively, but that shouldn't make much difference right here.
It really shouldn't, but a lot of coaches look at it similar to baseball with the intentional walk.
Always bringing in other sports.
Always, hey, listen, think about the intentional walk, right? What if one gets past the catcher? What if he uncorks a wild one and now you still have an opportunity? That's why they like to use them all the way through.
And now the Bears going to signal for another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. Only one timeout defensively, so this should just be a simple kneel down.
I agree totally. I looked at my time management chart. It says take a knee, victory formation. They just have one timeout left, and that should be all she wrote.
By the way, it's a good thing you can read that because nobody else can.
Not with my chicken scratch, not at all.
Victory very much in sight now as they'll take a knee. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. They lost two, and it brings up fourth. Out now comes the Cowboys punter. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first.